like I said, this was the Goka earthquake of Nepal, which happened in April 2015. It nearly killed 9,000 people and injured 22,000 people. The act of nature creates a catastrophic situation which affects the day-to-day pattern of life, and people are plunged into helplessness and suffering. According to the 2013 civil registration data released by the Census Directorate, nearly 27% people who die during the natural disasters are the victims of lack of timely response, which means 3 out of 10 are the victim of the same. Knowing this, that timely response is such a great, such a significant factor in saving life, it's still a matter of great concern. And this is just one small example. There are many such calamities which happen around us. Yeah, this is Nepal and where the earthquake epicenter was. And although the medical camps were arranged, but there was no direct route to them because of the devastation happened during the natural earthquake. So people had to take a different route, which was very time consuming, and it was an undeniable situation, but basically you cannot do much about it. So in response to this, IBM Call for Code, along with the David Clark cause, has initiated a developer event, which is a global event where we are looking for technological solutions which are used for at the time of natural disaster for preparedness, response and recovery. The motto behind the Call for Code is make use of the open source technologies and create technologies out of it for the healthcare, which can reduce the risk of diseases, greatly impact the options which are there at the time of medical or emergency care, improve data and resource availability. So for Call for Code, this is our solution which we have come up with. So which is a first means of help for the people who are affected during natural disasters. So basically, in order to achieve that, we are providing virtual assistance to the affected people who are affected and cannot be given timely response by the medical practitioners who are readily available to help the people, but due to the limitation that they cannot reach the natural disaster prone area, they can virtually assist them. And in order to do so, we have used Watson APIs, we have leveraged them.
Yeah, so hello everyone. So this is the high level architecture of our model. So as you can see on the top left side, we are using a customized self-assembled drone. So over the drone, we have mounted a Raspberry-Pi device, which will be interfaced with a Pi camera. So the camera will be capturing the live video stream of all the surrounding objects, and it will detect which category of object it belongs to. So it can be a person or a car or a bus and so on. So once it recognizes that if it is a person, then it will capture the images of the person from various angles, then it will send those images to the visual recognition model which we have created using Watson APIs. So we have trained this model with over 5,000 images of both injured people and non-injured people. So based on the images, it will identify whether the person is injured or not. So if it detects that a person is injured, then it will directly make a call to a physician, so that physician can guide the person like what first aid he should apply at that moment, or if any volunteer is nearby, he can help that person in applying the first aid so that the severity of the injury does not increase. So if the model detects that a person is not injured, then it will the person will be provided with a questionnaire which will consist of a behavioral kind of questions like how are you feeling, or are you in any kind of pain, or such questions. So the responses of the person will be captured using a microphone which will again be mounted over the drone. So the responses which are recorded will be sent to speech to text Watson service. There it will be converted to text service, text form. Then that text will be converted to an NLP model which we have created using natural language understanding service of Watson. So the NLP model, based on specific keywords and the algorithm which we have created, it will identify that whether a person is in any kind of internal injury is there, or he is suffering from any epidemic which may occur during the disasters and all, or he is suffering from any kind of mental trauma. So if the person is suffering from any disease or something, then a call will be made to a general doctor who can suggest the person like what medicines he should take on further. And if it identifies that the person is suffering from any mental trauma, then a call will be made to a psychiatrist or a counselor who can calm down the person and tell him like what further steps he need to take. So this was our model. So for the object detection model, we have used the code patterns. So these code patterns are readily available in the open source platform of IBM. So you can check that out on developer.ibm.com, and Yuktesh will be talking about that afterwards. So you can see from the demo, like even the picture of a person taken from behind, it was able to detect with a good accuracy, around 60 to 70%. And also the with the cat, a little blurred image was there, still it was able to recognize with a good accuracy. So in case of disasters, we might not have the high resolution image. We might get a low resolution image or not a proper image. We might have a partial image of a person or such cases. So in that case also, our model is able to detect with a certain accuracy. So it can be relied upon, you can see. So these are some sample outputs from our object detection model. So you can see how it is able to differentiate between living things and non-living things. Like in case of fourth image, you can see there are 4 to 5 objects. Still it is able to detect the category of the objects with a accuracy of over 90%. So now coming to the cost analysis part. So the complete cost of our hardware component of our model comes around 18.5k in Indian rupees. So you can see like it is even less than that of a smartphone which we buy nowadays. So even if our model is able to save a single life, even then it can be totally worthy of the resources which are spent in making this model work. So this is the image of our drone model. So you can see how we have mounted the Rasberry-Pi component over the drone. So this is the green thing is the Rasberry-Pi. The band-like structure which you are seeing is the Pi camera, which is interfaced with that. And this blue color device is the GSM module with an antenna, which will be used for making the calls to the doctors. Now coming to the demo. So this is the dashboard application of our project. So from here we can directly give some input, whether it's image or an audio clip which will be recorded. So suppose we want to check for external injury, so we will select that and we will give the image of a person who is injured. So suppose we upload the image of an injured person. So once we analyze this in the backend, the a visual recognition model API will be invoked, and that will give the results that a person is injured. So you can see the it is giving that person is injured, and it is able to give an accuracy of 92%. So our model can be relied upon. So suppose we check for a non-injured case. So again, we will select the external injury type and upload the, now we are uploading the image of a non-injured person. So once it is uploaded, it will analyze. Now it will invoke the same API of the visual recognition model, and this time it is giving that the person is not injured. And again, it is giving a good accuracy of 89%. So if now it will go to perform other tests if the person is not injured. So it will check for general health issues like some epidemic or some internal injuries. So now we will upload the audio file. So it will be the response of the victim, which is captured using the microphone mounted over the drone. So once we analyze this, it will invoke two services. First, it will convert speech to text. After that, it will call the.
I'm not physically hurt, but I'm having a headache, and I have a feeling that I might faint.
So the audio was uploaded, and it translated it into text. And over that text, based on certain keywords, it performed NLP. So we can, it can identify that the person is suffering from some general health issue, and accuracy also it is able to give 81%. So it will directly make a call to a general doctor who can suggest some medicines or something. Now we can check for the case if some mental trauma or something is there with the person. Again, we will upload the audio file. Then again, two services of Watson will be called.
My mental condition is not stable. I don't know what to do. I am in need of help.
So here, based on certain keywords like mental condition, not stable, it figured out like the person is not in a proper mental state. So it identified like he is in mental trauma. So now the call will be made to a psychiatrist or a counselor. So here also you can notice that accuracy is 78%. So we have also maintained a database of that all the available and non-available doctors. So like there will be three categories, general physicians, counselors, and emergency doctors. So once a call is made to a doctor, and if he is attending some victim, then the status of that doctor will be shown with the red symbol. That means the call will not be again made to that doctor. And if he is available, then he will be marked with a green tick symbol.
Thank you, Pragun. So here, in order to do that, we are getting help from all the medical practitioners who are there, who want to help but cannot be there physically. So with that, lot of people can be of help, and we can provide. We can basically save, like the data I showed, like 3 out of 10 people who died due to timely response or lack of timely response, they can be treated in a more timely manner. So this is not a basically, these doctors are prescribing that so that when they reach to the medical camps or whenever they reach to any place where they can get all these medicines or any kind of help, they need not have to stand in a queue or to get it rectified or get it checked by another doctor. They can straight away go and tell that this has been prescribed to me, and I can be straightly given a help by the doctors or whoever is readily available there. We have Yuktesh here, who is going to talk about detail about the code patterns and other things which IBM is doing in this case.
So basically, I'm here to spend 10 minutes time with you to showcase few places in IBM wherein you can able to get some stuff, what our guys have told you, where you can able to go ahead and explore those stuff. Okay, that's the reason I'm here. So let me quickly take you through a few places of in IBM where if you are a developer, okay, this is a one shop stop for you, wherein you can able to find lots of stuff, be it tech, you know, if it is a code pattern, it's a tutorial, it's a video stuff, events, right, whatnot, every other, it's kind of central place. If you are a developer, you can come here and explore. It's all self-explanatory. And as our colleague said, code patterns, this is very interesting stuff. If you are a good experienced developers, if you would like to, it's not like only for enablement as such, rather, you know what, ABC technology, you know, clubbing together and, you know, would like to see in the form of a POC, right? This is the right spot for you. There are like 300 plus code patterns have been built by IBMers and kept here for you in single spot, like, you know what, in matter of 3 to 5 minutes, you could able to get the end-to-end field view about that application. So it's good for you to explore. And then, you know what, if this is something inclined with your, you know, thought process or idea, maybe you can do that sort of fine tuning, and then, you know what, you can able to leverage this. Okay. So our guys again leveraged IBM Cloud, Watson, AI stuff and all, they are showcasing you, right? So there is a link straight away you can get over here, and catalog is the place where you can find a whole lot of IBM Cloud providing services. And AI is a thing which I highlighted. You can find a dozen place APIs over there, which you can quickly go through them. Yeah, so how many of you have startups here? Oh, I could see like 10 plus hands. Great. So if you are a startup, so this is what the place for you. We do have a program called Startup with IBM. If you are early stage startup, by the way, when I say early stage, less than 5 years of old, right? So be it B2C, B2B, right? So you can come over here, you can leverage IBM Cloud. You will be getting some kind of credits, like per month, $1,000 credits. Likewise, for 1 year, you'll be getting. And you will be not only technology help, but also, you know what, once if you are on platform, right, we will be helping you to connect our sales team, right, to help you in terms of business perspective. And also, we do also support in terms of, you know, investment pitches. Like if you are looking for investments, we do have a pool of investors, like VCs, IBM, execs, angels. So these are the folks. We have pool of community guys, so we can able to help you out if you are with us. Okay, so again, for self-enablement, if you are keen towards exploring Watson, which is IBM AI engine, right, this is what the place where you can come and, you know, explore. And so how many of you know this portal, cognitiveclass.ai, by any chance? Okay, great. So again, I can see another 10 plus hands. Great. So this is kind of external portal where you don't see anywhere IBM as such, but this is what been supporting by IBM. You can find whole lot of you know, batch programs, okay, in the area of data science ML, right, which all been supporting by IBM. Straight away you log in, you explore, you join as, you know, courses, and it's lots of, again, tech stuff. You complete the courses, you earn badge that kind of acknowledge that you are good at. Okay, so, yeah, net, so coming to final stuff. So, how many of you are from Hyderabad here? Probably 80%. So this is for you. So I run a meetup group. Okay, how many of you know meetup.com? Yeah, so guys, the other people who haven't raised, you have to really explore. This is the place where, you know, like-minded people will come together and explore, share knowledge, right? So we do conduct lots of meetups. It's kind of, you know, tech events, I can say, 3-4 hour meetup, half a day meetup. Maybe sometimes full day meetups. On a Saturdays, most probably on a weekends we conduct. It's kind of mind sharing, give back. Okay, so we conduct, so some 50 plus events I have conducted in the last couple of years. On average, monthly 2, right? You can see upcoming 3 events, right? So all the tech areas, again, be it, you know, end to end, again, you know, if it is language perspective, if it is product perspective, if it is cloud perspective, AI, ML, anything. So irrespective of the technology, right? So we do conduct lots of meetups. So people who are in Hyderabad, if you would like to learn on, you know, IBM AI stuff, right, you can join our meetups. And if you are a speaker, if you would like to contribute, if you would like to give back, please do consult, that we are happy to provide stage for you. Okay, so these are all the quick links which I have showed till now. Maybe this is a single snapshot if you can take, that will be helpful. Later on you can explore. Okay. So that's it from my end. So thanks for your time.